Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This week I am playing the deck you've been waiting for, Blue-Red Twin. As you've seen on ChannelFireball.com, I have a series on Blue-Red Twin in which I go over each matchups and talk about how to play them, and some interactions, and how to sideboard. So this week, unfortunately, I can't be playing an aggregate list like I am showing in the articles, because obviously that would be terrible. So I have my own personal list of Blue-Red Twin. It's fairly standard. The huge difference is the second Vendilion Click, which most people usually play in the sideboard. I like it main deck. I have a Jace Vryn's Prodigy over the four Snapcaster Mage. This is something I've been trying out recently, and it doesn't seem to make much sense. But over like the last year, I always felt like the four Snapcaster Mage was a little bit too much. It's obviously great in the late game, but I really hated having two early, especially if you don't have a Lightning Bolt or like a cheap spell to flashback with it. So I wanted another 2-drop, because your only real 2-drop is Remand. So Jace is, like, in the late game, it's close to, it's a little bit worse than Snapcaster Mage, although sometimes it is better. Like, if it lives, it loots you away a land, and then flashback something and stays in play, it's just going to be better than actual Snapcaster Mage. So I think we're losing sometimes a little bit of value in the late game, but I'm gaining the value that I can play on turn two, and it's been fairly good like on turn two so far, so I like it. And it's also sweet to have a loot effect. We have this Lighthouse loot effect, and some people play a second one, but the reason I want loot effects is that I'm playing a Spell Pierce, which is it's not a card I liked in Twin in general, just because the games usually go long and then it just becomes bad. But the thing is that it's really good in early game. It's usually better than the third Dispel, like as a more versatile card. So that's why I wanted the Spell Pierce, just as a card, like some sort of Dispel that does something early game that also interacts with other spells such as Eye of Mine and whatever, and some affinity cards. And basically because it's bad in a late game, I like having some loot effects like Lighthouse and Jace so I can get rid of it. I wouldn't play Spell Pierce if I didn't have at least two loot effects. So if you didn't play Jace and you wanted to play Spell Pierce, I would play a second Lighthouse. And I actually tried the second Lighthouse. I like it. The only reason I don't have it is for room reasons. Like, I really want the Cavernous Souls in my 75, because it's so good in the mirror. I used to have it in a sideboard and boarded it as a 24 land in the mirror, and I had the second Lighthouse. But I really needed Infect has gained popularity recently, and basically the 16th card in my sideboard was Snapcaster. So I really wanted it. So what I had to do is cut the Cavern I had the sideboard, put it back in the main deck, and cut the second Lighthouse I had. I could be playing three colorless lands, but I'm not a fan of it. I just dislike that. Especially since I think Sulphur Falls is one of your best lands. I want to play four, and by playing more colorless lands, well, they become worse, or you have to cut one. So it's mostly personal reasons. I have one Grim Lavamancer in the main deck. Some people play it in the sideboard usually. I like it in the main deck, and yeah, that's pretty much it. The sideboard is fairly standard. The only thing that's not is Spreading Seas. It's something that it's something that was played a few years ago in Twin, either main deck or sideboard, and I recently went back on it because, I mean, I'm saying recently, but I've been playing it for a year actually. And it's just so good against the black-green decks with Blood Moon. Because sometimes the problem with Blood Moon is that if they decide to play around it, it's going to be so bad. And if they play around it and you Spreading Seize them, like, it just screws them so much with the with your Blood Moons that I really like them. They're also good in other matchups. Like, they're really good against Tron, obviously. They're good against Burn and some very aggressive version of Zoo, because they don't have colorless, I should say, generic mana in their casting costs. So it's basically, it reads two mana, destroy a land, and draw a card. So I like it against those decks. It's sometimes a board against Infect, although I'm not sure I should be doing that. But it stops Pendulhaven and it stops Inkmunt Nexus, so it's not the worst. It's also good against Boggles, for the same reason as Zoo and Burn. They have very few colorless casting costs in their cards, so it's fairly good. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. I mean, it's obviously good against like some other random decks. And basically any deck that I would bring in Blood Moon, I usually board in Spreading Seas as well. Pia and Kieran Nalar is fairly recent, but I think everyone caught on to it and just everyone's playing it. It's been phenomenal for me. It's so good against Affinity. It's good against Infect. Just like the colorless and flying creatures that it makes is just incredibly good. It plays around Wild Defiance also, because it's an ability and not a spell when you activate it. So yeah, all in all, I wish I could have a second Pia, but if I wanted to do that, I would have to cut a Keranos, I think, because I just don't want to have too many boom booms in a sideboard, and I think I would have to cut Keranos. And I board in more frequently than I board in Keranos, but the thing is, Keranos is for Jund and Black Green, which are some of your worst matchups, and Keranos is just better than Pia there. Just because they have no way to answer it, basically. So I don't want to cut down on the Keranos. I usually have Pyroclasm instead of Anger. I hate Anger just because it's 3 mana. But the thing is, Wild in the Cattle is quite popular these days, and I feel like I have to run Anger so I can actually have a shot against these decks. I mean, those are not terrible matchups, but Anger is really good against Voice and the Cattle. So I have Anger for the moment. But I usually like better Pyroclasm, because it's great against Burn when they don't have Nacatals, and it's great against Affinity and Infect, whereas Anger is not great in those matchups. So I'll be playing a Magic Online League. So follow me there.